A lot of business went down on Monday in the National Hockey League. Let's crash the net with what is trending. We start with the Toronto Maple Leafs, who strike a deal with the LA Kings. Left shot D-man Jake Muzzin headed to TO in exchange for a first-round draft pick at this year's draft, along with Carl Grundstrom and the rights to Sean Durzi. Here's general manager Kyle Dubas on the deal.
You know, I was a little shocked to get the phone call. You hear rumblings and rumors and stuff like that, and you just continue on with your ways, and then until it actually happens, then you're, you know, everything sinks in. So very excited to join Toronto. I was thinking about it, though. Just playing them, you know, how we got beat. I was like, damn. So, and now I'll be a part of that team. So it should be, I'm really excited for the opportunity.
When he joined Los Angeles, they were sort of at the same stage that we are now. So he has that experience of seeing a team mature from being someone, the team that wanted to contend, to contending, and then ultimately winning. And he was a big part of their championship team in 2014. Beyond all that, the key is his ability to play at the top end of our defense, play in all situations, play against the other team's top players. Just thought it'd be a great fit for our locker room as well.
All right, here's another look at the trade details. Leafs Nation wanted a top four defenseman. Leafs Nation gets a top four defenseman, thanks to Kyle Dubas. Guys, your initial reaction to the trade. Let's start there.
Well, I mean, Jake Muzzin is an experienced guy. He's been part of a championship team with the Los Angeles Kings, so that's good news. He's a left-hand shot, but he can play on the right side, so that's good news. And he's a big guy. He can shoot the puck. He can play well on his own end. He's a good player, and there's a chance that he's going to be a good fit for the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Probably the only shortcoming we as pundits, and yes, the Leafs Nation as well out there, have pointed to with respect to this Leafs roster is, are they good enough at the defense position? And I think this is a significant move in the right direction. I mean, to me, Ron Hainsey is now appropriately slotted third pairing. We'll move, assuming Muzzin moves to the left side, probably on a pairing with Morgan Riley. I think the Leafs are in a really good spot. Absolutely in a really good spot. A terrific upgrade at a critical position. And hey, they get a player who has great defensive upside, great offensive upside, a guy with another year left on his deal after this year, and a guy who comes at a pretty good value, just barely above the $4 million mark. I think that's a pretty good, that's a good value, EJ, for a top four defenseman in the NHL.
They addressed the need, and they didn't take anyone off their roster.
Yep.
So for me, yep, that works out. And for the LA Kings, hopefully, the prospects and the picks are individuals, and the future with the pick will be something that can help their franchise as they try to retool, rebuild down the road.
You're right. They are a better team after the deal, at least right now,
yeah,
than they
the
were
Leafs, yeah,
before
no
it. I love Muzzin with the plus 10 on a Kings team that is not very good this season. That kind of tells you what kind of player he is.
This is a guy, too, predominantly. He's, of course, a top four defender on the LA Kings, playing against top six competition on the other side. A struggling organization this year, the Kings were, yeah, and he still manages a plus 10. Says a lot about his abilities on the defensive side of the puck.
How beneficial is it for Kyle Dubas and the Toronto Maple Leafs that they were able to get this deal done almost an entire month before the actual trade deadline?
It's easy to overlook or understate how important that is. The earlier you can transition a player, especially an impact player, a guy who's going to chew up a lot of minutes for you, the earlier you can get him into camp, and it comes at a good time too. Remember, just coming out of the All-Star break, an extra few days off for the Toronto Maple Leafs, he gets to transition, settle family issues, gets a little practice time in with his new club. And, of course, there's that lead up to the trade deadline and then ultimately the playoffs, where he gets an opportunity to integrate into the lineup night after night basis. It takes a while to assemble a new player like this. So I think it's easy to overlook that piece of it. But Dubas made a lot of noise around that as he makes this transaction. It's important to acquire.
Yeah, I agree. Without question. And I can remember Jimmy Rutherford has talked about that in the past. And there's a guy that's been a manager in this league for a long time,
yeah,
Carolina, then Pittsburgh. And he has said that about those kind of acquisitions. So it will give Muzzin more time to get ready, to get into personal stuff, too.
Right. And let's keep an eye on this, too. Remember, that means, or at least increases the probabilities, there's still a good window for Toronto. Maybe they want to go out and acquire another guy. Maybe there's,
yeah,
another defender in mind.
Maybe
and
a right shot defenseman.
The last thing you want to do, even if you're introducing three impact players, but you do it right at the trade deadline, that can be disruptive to even a really strong roster. So integrating new parts earlier on, better for playoff aspirations, in my opinion. Seen it bear out that way many, many times.
Well, yeah, because I think the thing is, when you acquire a player, no matter how high a caliber a player, on the trade deadline day, it's like you're right into the thick of playoff races, and you're kind of on that home stretch right away. Jake Muzzin gets basically four extra weeks to sort of, you know, settle down. He's playing for his hometown team. It's a big deal. He cheered for the Leafs growing up. So he has time to sort of get acclimated with what Leafs Nation is all about. It's a little bit different than playing in L.A.
Yeah.
And he should be comfortable by the time they get down to that sort of final stretch run. One other question I wanted to ask you guys is, with the Leafs making this deal, I'm sure they weren't the only team interested in a Jake Muzzin. Does this put pressure on other teams in the East, like the Caps, like the Bolts, as good as they are, to try to make their club better?
I think any of the teams that are looking to acquire defensemen, and there are a number of teams that are looking to do that because you can never have enough of them around this time of year, it does kind of put a little bit of a jump in their step that if they have somebody they're looking at, they might want to get ahead of the game, and that's good for the sellers because they want to create that urgency and that kind of bidding war for particular players. So when you see something like this happen, sometimes dominoes start to fall.
Especially for general managers who are division rivals to the Leafs. You're always paying attention to, what did my rival, my closest rival, do around deadline time? How did they get better? You have to look at this Leafs situation and go, there was a shortcoming there, potentially. They've really helped to bolster their strength at that position.
Maybe a Boston Bruins team looking to maybe feeling like, maybe we should address one of our situations. I guess time will tell if the Leafs or any other team in the East is looking to make a move in the near future. Let's look at the LA Kings side of the equation.
Yeah.
Is this the official start of a sort of rebuild for the Kings?
I think it is. I think they are going to start to move some of these other guys out, too. I think like an Alec Martinez is someone that'll have a lot of value. Talk about a defenseman.
Right.
He's been part of those championships as well and has had some big moments in those games. So I think there'll be some teams that are looking at him. I think we hear Tyler Toffoli, his name is out there. They may have a couple of other guys that they look to move as well. So I think Rob Blake is looking to change the dynamic of things. I think he's looking to get younger and faster, and you do so by going out and acquiring draft picks. And the two guys he got were both second-round picks. Grundstrom is viewed as a potential third-line type of guy. One scout I talked to says he's got good size, straight-ahead type of player, and he's got decent skills. So he visions him as a third-line type, which is, you got to have those guys. And Durzi is someone that is a smallish defenseman but really made strides. He was skipped over in the 2017 draft, but then was a second-round pick in 2018 and has played very well in the Ontario Hockey League, playing for Guelph now after playing for most of his career in the OHL with Owen Sound. So these are two players that they're going to have an accelerated opportunity in L.A. where there's going to be more job openings, so to speak, as the team retools, rebuilds.
I think now the Muzzin transaction marks an important shift in philosophy and emphasis for the L.A. Kings. Rob Blake now looks to his scouting staff. Guys, go out. I have pieces here, ready-made pieces that can help other teams that I need to parlay into assets, picks, and prospects. Go out and identify people for me who can help us build long-term.